Hello everyone, now we'll be starting our new concept, that is trigonometric identities. So first of all, we have to understand what are identities. What do you mean by an identity? So as you can see on the screen, I have already written the definition there. An identity is an equation if it is true for all values of the variables. So you are aware of the equation. It consists of variables. It may be one variable, two variable, three variable equations. So for example, I have written a single variable equation, that is x square minus 16 is equals to x plus 4 into x minus 4. So of course, you can make out that it is using the identity a square minus b square is equals to a plus b into a minus b. So this holds true for all values of x. This holds true for all values of x. Whatever you substitute the x, you make x 1, 2, 3, 4, whatever you make it, it will remain true. So such equations are called identities, which is true for all value of the variables. But this is an algebraic equation or algebraic identity. So if an equation or identity is written using the trigonometric ratio, then that is called trigonometric identity. So in this chapter, there is not much of theory. What we will be doing will be proving some basic trigonometric identities, and then we will be moving on towards the problems where we will be using those basic trigonometric identities that we will be proving to solve the problems, more complex problems. So let's start with some trigonometric identities that are to be proven, some basic trigonometric identities. So now we will start with our first trigonometric identity, the very common trigonometric identity, that is sine square theta plus cos square theta is equals to 1. So in this case, we will start with first case. Here three cases arises, and theta can be 0 or 90 degree or any other acute angle. So we'll take the case 1 when theta equals to 0 degree. If theta is 0, then sine 0 is 0 and cos 0 is 1. Therefore, sine square 0 plus cos square 0 will be, sine square 0 will be 0, cos square 0 will be 1. So it will be 1. Therefore, in case of theta equals to 0, the sine square theta plus cos square theta equals to 1. So this identity holds good. So while proving the identity, what you have to keep in mind, that you have to prove that the identity holds true for all values of theta. So why are we breaking it into cases? Because 0 degree and 90 degree value we know. We know the value of sine 90, sine 0, cos 90 and cos 0. So we can easily prove it that way. We also know the value of 30, 45, 60, but we will not be doing those cases because those cases will already be covered in any other acute angle. And that we will be doing in a generic manner by using a right angle triangle. So basically, we have to prove that this identity holds good for all values of theta. 0 degree and 90 degree cannot be done through a right angle triangle. So we are using the specific value of sine 0, sine 90, cos 0, cos 90 to prove that sine square theta plus cos square theta equals to 1. So we will move on to case 2 when theta is equals to 90 degree. So sine of 90 degree is 1 and cos of 90 degree is 0. Therefore, sine square 90 plus cos square 90 is equals to 1 square plus 0. That is 1. So even if theta is 90, sine square theta plus cos square theta equals to 1 holds true. Now we'll do the third case. When theta is anything other than any other acute angle falling between 0 and 90 degree. So in order to prove that sine square theta plus cos square theta equals to 1 for any other acute angle, we will assume a right angle triangle ABC in which angle B is 90 degree and angle A is theta. So, as we have already discussed numerous times, that the side which is opposite to theta means the side which is opposite to the angle in reference of which we have to find the trigonometric ratio will always be marked as P, that is perpendicular. The other side containing the right angle. So, the BC is already marked P, the other side containing right angle is AB. That will be marked as base. And of course, AC will be hypotenuse. There is no confusion in hypotenuse. Hypotenuse always remains the same wherever the theta is marked. So, in the triangle ABC, the value of sine theta is perpendicular by base. So, perpendicular is BC, base is AB. That is first equation. Now we will take out the value of cos theta. Sine theta is perpendicular by hypotenuse, not base. Sine theta is perpendicular by hypotenuse. So perpendicular is BC, hypotenuse is AC. Similarly, cos theta is base by hypotenuse. Base is AB, hypotenuse is AC. Now we will square both the equation 1 and 2. So we will write squaring and adding equation 1 and 2. So if you square left hand side of equation 1 and 2, you will get sine square theta plus cos square theta is equals to our right hand side, BC by AC whole square plus AB by AC whole square. Now if you focus on the right hand side, then you will get BC square by AC square plus AB square by AC square. That means if you take LCM as AC square, then the numerator will be BC square plus AB square. Now have a look at the right angle triangle. BC square plus AB square, shouldn't it be equal to AC square as per Pythagoras theorem? So BC square plus AB square will be equals to AC square. Here, as I have told earlier, please write using Pythagoras theorem. I am not writing the same, but you'll have to write it in the exam. Using Pythagoras theorem, substituting BC square plus AB square equals to AC square. You will have to write like this in the examination. Please write it now. So AC square gets cancelled. That becomes 1. Therefore, we have proved that sine square theta plus cos square theta equals to 1 for any other acute angle. So this identity is now proved. Now we'll be using this identity in solving the problems of this chapter. Now let us move on to the next identity. You please note it down. You can pause the video and note it down. Now one more result follows from this sine square theta plus cos square theta equals to 1. Sine square theta plus cos square theta equals to 1. Then 1 minus sine square theta equals to cos square theta, or 1 minus cos square theta is equals to sine square theta. These results also we will be using in our problem directly, because these are nothing but a derivative of sine square theta plus cos square theta equals to 1. You can easily interchange the sine and cos, and you can get this result. If you take cos this side, 1 minus cos square theta is sine square theta. If you take sine this side, 1 minus sine square theta is cos square theta. So now our next identity is 1 plus tan square theta is equals to sec square theta. Now, as in the previous identity, here also we will be taking a right angle triangle A, B, C. Similarly, we will be marking angle as theta. Now, you are well versed with how to mark a side as perpendicular, which side to mark as perpendicular, which side to mark as base. So, this is a right angle triangle ABC, in which angle B is 90 degree. We have assumed angle C as theta. So, the side opposite to theta, that is AB, is to be marked as perpendicular. Now, we'll start from left-hand side. Left-hand side gives us 1 plus tan square theta. 1 plus tan square theta. Now, tan theta is perpendicular by base. So, we'll write like this, perpendicular by base. So, 1 plus perpendicular is AB. Base is BC square. So, 1 plus AB square by BC square. Now, we'll take BC square as LCM. So, it becomes BC square plus AB square. Now, you see in this triangle, AB square plus BC square, it should be equal to AC square by Pythagoras theorem. So, again here you'll have to write using Pythagoras theorem, AC square equals to BC square plus AB square. I am directly writing it, but you write it using Pythagoras theorem. The value of BC square plus AB square is AC square. So, LHS comes to be AC square plus BC square. We'll take at equation 1 and we'll move on to the right hand side. Right hand side is sec square theta. Now, sec theta we know is hypotenuse by base square. Hypotenuse is AC. Base is BC square. That is AC square by BC square. Now, you can see the left hand side and right hand side both are AC square by BC square. Therefore, 1 plus tan square theta will be equals to sec square theta. 1 plus tan square theta will be equals to sec square theta. From this, we can also derive that sec square theta minus tan square theta will be equals to 1. How? If you take this tan square theta, this side, sec square theta minus tan square theta will be equal to 1. So, these proving these identities are very, very easy, and it is highly unlikely that these identities, proof of these identities, will be asked in your examination. But anyhow, you should know it, how to prove it. And it's not that difficult, it's very, very easy. You just have to draw a right angle triangle, mark the sides as perpendicular, base and hypotenuse, and then derive the value of left hand side and right hand side in terms of sides of the triangle. Once you derive left hand side and our right hand side, both will come to be the same. And so, you will be proving your trigonometric identities. Similarly, we will be proving our third trigonometric identity. I am not removing this triangle because this triangle we will be using in our next identity also. Next identity is 1 plus cot square theta equals to cosec square theta. So, first of all, just write cot theta. Cot theta is base by perpendicular. That is, base is BC. Perpendicular is AB. Similarly, cosec theta will be equals to hypotenuse by perpendicular. Hypotenuse is AC. Perpendicular is AB. Now, we will be using these two values in left hand side as well as right hand side. In left hand side, it is 1 plus cot square theta. So, 1 plus cot theta we have already derived BC by AB. Again, in examination, you will be writing here using equation number 1. Because from equation 1, you have substituted the value of cot theta to be BC by AB. So, 1 plus BC square by AB square, if you take AB square as LCM, so it will come AB square plus BC square. Now again, if you say in this right angle triangle, AB square plus BC square is nothing but AC square by Pythagoras theorem. So AB square plus BC square is equals to AC square. So this is second equation. Now again, here you will have to write using Pythagoras theorem, AC square is equals to AB square plus BC square. In examination, never miss to mention what formula you have used. This is very, very essential. Now we'll be moving on to the right hand side. Right hand side it is cosec square theta. The value of cosec theta we have derived AC by AB. Again here write using equation 1, cosec theta is AC by AB. In the bracket you mention this AC by AB square. So it is equals to AC square by AB square. Make it equation 3. Now since equation 2 and equation 3 are equal, so LHS is equals to RHS, that is left hand side is equals to right hand side. So 1 plus cot square theta is equals to cosec square theta. Hence the identity is proved. As a derivative of this identity, you can also say that cosec square theta minus cot square theta is equals to 1. Now we will be moving on to the next identity. So we have proved 3 of the major trigonometric identity. Now we'll be summarizing them. First trigonometric identity that we learned was sine square theta plus cos square theta equals to 1. From this flows two more trigonometric identities. First is 1 minus sine square theta is equals to cos square theta. The second one is 1 minus cos square theta is equals to sine square theta. So this was the first trigonometric identity. The second trigonometric identity that we learned was 1 plus tan square theta is equals to sec square theta. From this flows two trigonometric identity. First is sec square theta minus tan square theta is equals to 1. And the second is sec square theta minus 1 is equals to tan square theta. In fact, if you expand this second, this one, sec square theta minus tan square theta. So sec square theta minus tan square theta is in the form of a square minus b square. So we can break it like a plus b into a minus b. In this form we can break it. So in this form it will become sec theta plus tan theta into sec theta minus tan theta equals to 1. Therefore we can also have sec theta plus tan theta is equals to 1 by sec theta minus tan theta. See, the basic trigonometric identity is only 1 plus tan square is sec square. Sine square plus cos square is 1. Others all are its derivatives. But we are showing it here only because if you are aware of it, you can directly use it in questions. Otherwise, in questions, you can derive it in two steps. The third trigonometric identity that we saw was 1 plus cot square theta is cosec square theta. From this one also flows two other trigonometric identities, that is cosec square theta minus cot square theta is equals to 1 and cosec square theta minus 1 is equals to cot square theta. So these are the trigonometric identities that we are supposed to know. Now we will be using these trigonometric identities in solving the problems. It will make it very, very easy to solve the problems relating to trigonometric identity. So in the next video lecture, we will move on to the problems relating to trigonometric identity. If you like the video, please press the like button and subscribe to our channel. You will be getting various updates that we will be releasing slowly regarding maths, and we are planning to move forwards to other subjects of class 10th also. Thank you.